You ready to go?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
My mother doesn't know about this. She blames all her gray hair on me. I can see why. All the actions that I have. I have a lot of accidents, but I tend to live through all of them. I started skydiving when I was 16. I think a lot of it's for the excitement, for the adrenaline rush on it. I'm not being naive about this. I mean, I know I could be hurt seriously or killed, but I think in this situation, if any thing did go wrong as far as mishap, I wouldn't. It's either one or the other. It's not kind of an in-between because that building's 1,350 feet high, and it's not like you could really have an accident and live through it, so it's going to be one or the other.
This is the exit, the entrance where we'd come up the escalator onto this part here. We'd go over here, the one fence that's the easiest to jump right here, we'd go over here, I'd run down along here, over to here. And the wind's coming from the west like this. It'd be best to, I'd rappel right here, this is about maybe 10, 15 feet at the most. You get about a foot, foot and a half ledge here. We'd get to this point here, unhook the rope, get my pilot shoot out.
Something to use and do, get the actual parachute onto the roof and do it without anybody knowing. I've got a parachute up with me, obviously. Gone through this a few times. I've been up on the roof already just with this load of, you know, with clothes to kind of fill it up and weight it down. And just seeing how they react. I'm going up there with a backpack on, which I really didn't get a second look. I'm going to make sure the security guard's over on the opposite side of the walkway. After I pull this out, just reach down. Flip it over. Well, out there practice this a little.
I've got some close-ups of the gate, barbed wire, and it's going around the perimeter there. Uh-huh. And
helps to work in a photo store, huh?
Oh, yeah. Makes everything quite convenient. We'll run these through and see how they come out. It says electric fence. I figure I can get over this fence and down the other side within 5 seconds, no problem.
Walk over to the edge, pull this out here. I have this in my hand, pop the rubber band, and have this situation here. Get over to the edge, say a few prayers, look down, go out, jump for about, I'd say about a good 3 second delay, and I, as soon as I went off, I'd be in this arch position here, bringing my hands down slowly like this, and with your hands down here, it's gonna tend to push you out more away from the building. Straightening your legs after 3 seconds, let that go there.
Then comes the moment of truth, whether a parachute was packed with the shit or not. John!
What's that?
Oh. Oh my god, on your hair. I mean, your face. That makes everything stay.
Every girl that walked by the store.
Hi. He talks to everybody.
How are you?
He sees all girls.
You, it's like, touching. Yeah. Touching.
Feel touching?
Yeah.
Well, did he have a lot of girls in the mall? I mean, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Like, in about every store in the mall.
Including the older women?
Oh, yeah.
I saw him with a girl. The first time I saw him with this girl, blonde-haired girl. But then again, later on that night, he was hitting on my boss. And then 2 days later, he comes over and he hits on me. And then he talks about this girl that is a serious girlfriend in Texas. So I don't think he knows which way he's going.
People around here, or most people around here, there are a few decent ones, so they tend to, when they're getting ready to do something, just almost anything, they tend to think, well, what's, you know, so-and-so gonna think? What are my friend's going to think. You know, they don't stop to think, well, am I going to enjoy it? How am I going to feel about it?
Why did he want to jump off the World Trade Tower?
To prove his manhood, which is probably why he chases after girls, drives a big truck or a big Jeep, and, you know, just acts the way he does. He's kind of rough when it comes to having fun. Like, you know, we'd fool around in the store and, you know, we'd tickle him or something like that. And instead of tickling his back, he'd whack us around and throw us on walls. Yeah. You know, he was just too rough for, you know, his own good and for our own good. You know, I guess he just did it to prove that he has balls.
My ex-girlfriend, my spring, she, you know, was really protected by her mother. She, you know, wasn't allowed to go flying with me. She'd be afraid to let me let her go on my Jeep with me. Really very overprotective of her. And about 3 weeks ago, she was killed in a car accident, only 18 years old. Didn't have her seatbelt on, but other than that, she just led a really safe life. And looking at something like that, as far as things I do, you know, well, when it's your time, you're gonna go. I can land right here, okay? But you'll be able to tell, see that when I'm going over you, if it looks like I can land here. This is a lot easier to land in. And you have to walk around the indoor viewing area to get to the escalator going up the roof. She'll wait like right by the bathrooms there with that parachute on, with, you know, packed with a parachute in it. I'm gonna go up, and if they search me there, they've never searched me yet, but just in case they do,
right.
You know, I've just got clothes on my back.
Right.
You know, no problem. So I go up, and a quick run around and come down the down escalator on the other side of the building. I'll go right past her, and just she'll have the back exit, and I'll just set it down and take the other one. And I'll go through again. And even if they do search me the first time, you know, I'm
right.
The same guy 5 minutes later. Same backpack, hey, you know, just still got clothes in it.
It was 3 times when I drove the pack, and they never searched, never even looked at me twice. It's a real pisser to have all you guys come down here for this.
You guys think he'll do it again?
No, I don't think so.
I don't think so.
Why don't you think he'll do it again?
I don't think he's coming back here to do that now.
Right after, I thought, you know, yeah, he would come back because I really thought he wanted to do it, but no, I don't know. I don't think he'll come back.
That's about all I've thought about. It's been my pretty much my main goal since I failed last year at it. Thinking about it on the average about 3 or 4 hours a day. Constantly before I go to sleep, I'm thinking about it for an hour or two, and that kind of gets my adrenaline going, and I have trouble falling asleep. course I would love to do it last year, but I'm almost glad that I did have a year to really think it out, because a lot more has gone into the planning and the training and that, because I had never done one previous to this September, this last September, and going off the building would have been my first, and now I've got four other ones, so it's really given me kind of an insight to it, and just so I know what to expect.
That's one of my secrets for this year. Normal, ordinary sweatshirt. Nope. Parachute on underneath, over the edge. This is it. This is gonna be the year.
He's up on top.
Fuck the gear! Fuck the gear, let's go! Yeah. Bad boy for breaking her heart.